Why hello there, good people of the earth. Shams Nelson here from Fantastic Anatomy, and in this video I'm going to go through my anatomy book collection and share with you what I think of each one, and hopefully it'll help you pick out which anatomy books you'd like to get. And I also even have a surprise anatomy book, which is one of my favorites, which has helped me draw anatomy, but is actually not an anatomy book at all. So stay tuned for that at the end, at the bottom of this pile. So let's get started. Okay, so artistic anatomy, this is apparently the great French classic on artistic anatomy. And this is a good book just for like references. See, it goes through every bone. These are nice where it shows the bone and then the outline of the muscles on there. It goes through, see, here's another one. And then this one's very basic, like it goes through all the different views. Oh, I guess I have some papers in here. And it also breaks down the muscles like individually, and then you'll see, okay, so here's the arm with all the muscles, but then it also, this is for the leg, but so it goes through all the little individual muscles on the leg, and then it shows you the full leg from front, back, and side views. So it's really good for reference. I feel like the drawings are very clean, so you can see all the different muscles. It's not too complex, it's black and white. And then here they also have it drawn out like how you'd see it on the surface of the form, so that's pretty nice to have too. So it's really good for reference. This is pretty cool, this guy doing this, turning his head in different ways. Oh my gosh. Okay, in the back, and it shows the muscles, and then more rendered on the front. So yeah, I think this is a great reference book. The text was pretty darn dry and boring. I'll like read you an excerpt, I guess. The upper arm has a cylindrical form in lean subjects and in women. However, if the muscles are developed, it becomes flat on the sides. It is wider from front to back than from side to side. So, I mean, like, it has, like, all this detailed information which you could learn by observing, but it's written out for you, and there's, like, pages upon pages of this in the beginning. So, I never really read that, but if you're into that, then there you go. This book's pretty cool. Atlas of the human anatomy for the artist, and I like this because it also has like the regular, like it shows the bones and stuff, and kind of similar to, here, let me adjust the angle so I'm not creating a shadow as much. Okay, so yeah, it shows like a lot of images of the bones and stuff, but then it has these pages, which I find are the most helpful. And these pages have kind of like helpful tricks, and like, not tricks, but like kind of like breaking things down in different ways. And they'll say like, oh, this looks like a horseshoe shape, and this looks like a this shape, like things that will just like random tips that will help you to draw things better, or to remember the shapes of things, etc., etc. These are shows like, okay, these two are opposite muscles that pull against each other. Like here shows them next to each other. See, look here, there's a little example. Shin curve, and then the S is like, you know, showing the curve of the shin, like. So it's kind of like, okay, I guess that's kind of fun. And then in the back, they also have kind of like in the other book, it almost looks like this is the same model. Funnily, if that's a word, funnily enough. And so it has a photograph this time, which I kind of like better than having the drawing, which was in the other book. And then it has a drawing of all the muscles in the same pose. Goes into interesting things like, okay, here, like the finger, you know, what is this? Oh, belly button? Okay. And then got some good things about breaking down a little bit on proportion and stuff like that. So it's pretty good overall, got lots of different stuff to help you out. And then here are some photographs, even like body types. So then how like fat hangs, and then equilibrium and locomotion, distinctions in sex and race. So it's kind of, it goes into stuff like this, showing children and stuff. It's pretty comprehensive, I think. And then some photographs for references of different stuff. And then there's a section on expression. Where are the images? And the text here, I think, is a little more, I still don't read very much of this, there's a lot of text, but yes, it breaks, it's very methodical, I feel like. It goes through every section very well, showing different references and stuff like that. And then I think there's a section, is it in this book? So you hear it like breaks it down a little more simply, so it's not like a super detailed drawing. I think there's a section in this book where I thought it was interesting. Oh, here it is. I like this page. So it shows people from different types of worlds, so you can around the world, so you can kind of see how the bone structure and features are different between different people. So I thought that was a kind of cool reference. So I would actually say this book I like better than the first one, if you were going to get a book to learn artistic anatomy. Now here, this book I'm actually not that into. I think I got it. Oh no, this book is cool. This book is Figure Drawing, Design, and Invention. And this one comes, like, a lot of people recommend this book. And this one is very interesting. This one's a lot more fun to read, so I actually started reading it from the beginning. It starts with gesture drawing, and then it moves into more advanced things, and it really shows, like, a lot of, like, what to do, what not to do, how to think, you know, stuff like that. And the text is actually pretty short and snippy. So let's see, the figure should be drawn using the straight C and S curves, lines to quickly capture the story. Main attention to the pose portions will be judged based on overall appearance of what you have drawn. So yeah, it's like that's a little quick snippy piece. Like, oh, okay, so C, S, and I curves, I can use that. Very helpful. It's not like the writing here isn't like extremely like technical or anything like that. And I feel like the drawings are very helpful. They kind of almost give you different ways of thinking. It's not just one method. Like here he'll use boxes and squares. Here he's using like contour lines to kind of get the feel for it. Here he kind of like experimented even by accentuating that box shape of the pelvis, so you can kind of get a feel for why you use a box shape and how that works. So there's different, all sorts of different ways. So you're like, there are lots of different images and different styles. And it's not like hyper, like, I mean, it is realistic, but it's not like hyper realistic in a way that's like very off-putting and like, oh man, I'll never draw like that. Some of them are actually don't even, in my opinion, they're like a little off, or they don't look as good as I'd like them to, or something like that. So, but I really like these ones where they use different colors and stuff like that. See, so here's another example. This is more smoothed out, realistic. Rendered here, he has it simplified and it shows half and half with the bone structure and the muscles on top. Really well laid out and very step by step too, so you can start at the beginning of the book and work your way through. It's got a great way of showing planes, so different planes and how that works, like it pretty kind of exaggerating what is important and what is useful for each thing. So here's the hand, you know, it's like, oh okay, that's a little basic shape. There's a thumb comes off, a little nub. So yeah, this is a great book. I definitely recommend this. And I think this book would be better than, like, if you're just getting one book, this might be the one to go with out of all the books I'm going to show you. This is the one where I'm like, eh, doesn't really help me that much. Has some basic principles and stuff like that, and some good information. But I think it's basically, like, it tells you, this book is more about how to think. So if you already have, like, a basis, and so it doesn't go into anatomy or anything like that. What is this book called again? Drawing People, How to Portray the Clothed Figure. So it's not necessarily an anatomy book per se. So if you've already got your anatomy down and you kind of like want to add more life and character to your things, or you're looking for details, like, okay, that's kind of cool. Using knees and elbows to indicate build. Okay, that's a good tip. But until you know how to draw knees and elbows and the clothes on top of it and all that stuff, it's not like the most helpful thing ever. Tells you what not to do. So this would be a good book. I think I'm going to revisit it once I feel like my clothed figure drawing is more, you know, to a level that I'd like it to be. I'll come back and revisit this, and it's good about clothes and stuff. So maybe when I'm drawing clothed figures, I'll come back and do that. And I like how it shows what not to do and stuff, and shows like common mistakes. So it's not a bad book or anything like that, but it wasn't as helpful for me initially learning figure drawing. So if you're more advanced, this might be an interesting book to look into. So now I'm going to come over and bring you I used to be really into Leonardo da Vinci, and when I was younger I used to get Leonardo da Vinci and Leonardo DiCaprio mixed up, but now I kind of figured that out. But so Leonardo da Vinci, I really liked him as an artist, and see his kind of anatomy study. So this, I have two books about him and or of his art. This one seems like it would be the one to look at, Mechanics of Man, but actually the other one I think was better. Anyways, so here, like, see, he's got the leg drawn out, and it's kind of interesting because it shows his studies, like thinner guys, like, and it's a little bit stylized in his own way and kind of breaks down different sections. Let's see, what are more so? Look at this claw foot, pretty weird. See, so here, that's nice, like that shows the leg pretty well. And I feel like it's a little easier to copy his examples. I don't know why, like here it kind of breaks down the neck in a very like stringy way, a little bit stylized, but very helpful, I think, to think of it this way or to understand it in this easy way. So this is the mechanics of man. But then here, this is one that just has his general, like all sorts of stuff. And they have a whole section about how his figure drawings. See, this in the mechanics of man, they mostly show his anatomy type drawings. They don't show these kind of drawings as much, where it is his sketches of the figures. So things like this are kind of nice. I don't know, I like how he breaks down the knee. You see that, like, that looks like a good way to break down the knee in simple forms. Here it's like side view, and I think the forms, like, then you can see the proportion of the upper, like the torso. He breaks down proportions in very interesting ways. If you know about the Venturian man, you know, he was kind of like, that was a big thing of him, trying to break down the proportion and see how like simplified that is. But it really shows the face. You're like, oh, I can just do the brows like that with a line like that and kind of get a feel for that. When I'm drawing, see here he does it again with the brows and kind of breaking down the form into different shapes. Here's another example of the face. So it's kind of cool to get inside his mind and see, so kind of showing proportions sitting down. Very like simplified in a way. Here's a Venturian man I was talking about. Is that his name? Venturian? I think so. Okay. You know, like here he's got it without the arm, so you can kind of see the form. So this is a good book. And oh, I bookmarked like two pages, I think. So then there's also sketches. Like, this is one thing that I really liked about Leonardo da Vinci, or one thing that helped me. See, it's like botanical anatomy. Let's see if that's in the anatomy section. See, it still has those anatomical ones from the other book in this one. You know, so that's kind of helpful, seeing how the skull looks from back view and stuff. All right, so let's go to where? Oh yeah, these, the grotesque faces. This actually helped me learn faces a lot more, because it was like, oh, look, he's breaking out form. There's the upper lip has its own form, the lower lip, like the nose and the brows, like it's pushed and exaggerated. Here it is pulled back, the nose, and it shows like the muzzle of the mouth, but it gives you a feel for the different sections, the chin, how it sticks out from under the lip, you know. So I like that. It's creeping foot again. And I bookmarked one other page on here to show you guys. Oh yeah, I guess because it's another kind of, see how the chin sticks out and the brows and everything. It's like the exaggeration, I feel like, really can help explain the forms better, because oh, look at this like bump behind his, where the fat kind of gathers or whatever. That's a nice little thing to know about. Or here you see this little lump right here. So it's also fun if you're doing characters and stuff to study his grotesque heads. So okay, I have the Secret Anatomy book hidden under here, but I wanted to share like two honorable mentions or something like that. Or I guess they're books I don't currently have in my collection, but I did at one point, or I checked them out from the library and I really liked them. And the first one I was surprised to find when I Googled it to show you guys is called, it's Andrew Loomis's Figure Drawing for All It's Worth. And this book is like, look, an opening chat. It's very conversational. For many years, blah, 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 you know, he's talking to you as an artist, almost like he's sitting in a room with you, helping you out. And he'll tell you, okay, here's my approach to figure drawing. And so let's show you some pages from this. And this, I just Googled Figure Drawing for All It's Worth, and apparently it's available to download as a PDF for free on goodreads.com. So if you just Google the book, it'll come up, like it's one of the, like the second or third thing. So here, it's like, see, this is a more simplified and in a nice way, I think. It's not overly simplified, but it's like simplified enough to help in like breaking down the different types of proportions and like, you know, I'll just kind of scroll through so you can get a feel for what he's doing here. There's one page that I really liked, and then showing, you know, like if you have contrapposto stance, different movements. It's pretty thorough. I like this page. So it shows you how to draw figures in perspective to each other from different views, and then here it shows like what different perspectives will achieve, kind of thing, like what
and what not to do. Like, this is some things that may happen when figures are not related to truth. The figure may appear tipped or somehow wrong. John may be falling, or Mary doing gymnastics. You know, like, it's kind of written in a fun way, more approachable. So this is a really cool book. I think it's really good. Here it shows, like, you know, his way of doing the skeleton, which is kind of unique. I like how he does the pelvis here, because it's kind of emphasizes the iliac crest. So that's a pretty cool landmark. So yeah, I think this is a very good book, and I'm probably going to add it to my collection at some point. But I guess I don't need to, because I just got it for free off Goodreads. So I don't know. I don't think that's illegal, because Goodreads is pretty big companies. I don't think they have that. So this goes on for a while. Okay, so bones, muscles. It's got like keep scrolling through to give you like a nice overview. And I think it goes from the kind of simple to the more advanced. So now you're seeing fully rendered figures and stuff like that. And I like how he talks like the atypical problem. What is this? Figure in action, twisting and turning. Very methodically broken down. So that's nice. I'll have to go through it more, but I guess I can't say too much more about that since I'm not that familiar with this book. Only went through like the first chapter or two at one point. And then last one is Dynamic Figure Drawing by Burne Hogarth. The other one was by Andrew Loomis. And also he has a book called like Drawing the Head and Hands. And all his books, and like, fun with a pencil and stuff. So Andrew Loomis is a fun artist to learn from. So this one has always been a book that kind of intimidated me, because if you don't already know anatomy pretty well, I don't think this book is going to be very helpful. But now that I've kind of studied each part individually, I can kind of see where he's really good at exaggerating, or like see like all these little the bumps on the body. This is right now just on amazon.com's preview, so you can get a lot out of it just by reading there if you don't have the book or you want to get it right away. So see how this is exaggerated, this shape, and all the shapes are very rounded, like this is very exaggerated. And the text here, I was just reading through a little bit, it seems pretty helpful, but mostly I think the images are where the help would come. So look at like this muscle, I don't think is usually quite as pronounced as it is there. Like here it's very much exaggerated. So yeah, this is a great thing I think to help like once you already know anatomy and you're looking to really like get it looking dynamic, as the book suggests, dynamic anatomy. I like his style and stuff, and I think he has amazing sense of proportion and muscles and stuff. So a little more advanced, but probably very helpful. Okay, cool. And so now the unveiling of the last book, which is not an anatomy book, but it's my favorite anatomy book, or one of them. Dun dun dun. Oh, I guess it is an anatomy book, just not an artistic anatomy book. And it's Strength Training Anatomy. And this actually, I didn't get for artistic anatomy. I got it because I was going to the gym and stuff. And I wanted a book that explained all the muscles and how to work them out and good form and stuff like that. But the reason this book is so great is because it's got a great mix of, here it's showing the bone, but the rest is a regular body. Here it's showing the upper muscles, but the rest is kind of a regular body. And it shows the sinews of the muscles, and it shows all these different body types. So, I mean, most of them are pretty buff, but I guess at least the guys, the women are like strong, but not like super, like superhero strong. I mean, this guy is pretty, you know, he's strong, but he's not like a bodybuilder per se, or not like a, you know, like the crazy buff guy. But then here, this guy is more getting to the crazy buff area. And so it's got a lot of different body types. So here, this woman is like, you know, not super duper buff. And so her muscle anatomy is not like really puffy or anything like that, and it shows them in all these crazy poses because it shows really the muscles moving in different ways that other anatomy books don't necessarily have. Like, when do you ever see a guy doing that pose unless he's, you know, pulling and doing that pull-up or whatever, that not pull-up but whatever that muscles that exercise is called. So yeah, so this is a great book, I think. And it also breaks down the muscles in like separate, like look at that, it shows, okay, here, you got the rib cage and the muscles on either side, so you can really see how it connects, and then it shows more rendered out realistic. So it's just got all these different views of the bones and muscles, and also the mechanics of how it works. Like, okay, that's what you can do, you're not supposed to do it while you're working out, but it shows the range of motion for different things. And then like here in the corners, oops,
it'll show like, oh, that's usually a standard thing that shows on every page. But look at that, it's got all different kinds of things and all different kinds of, even like if your muscle tears and stuff, like look at, it shows the bicep if it's torn, so you can be, oh, I'd want to avoid that unless I'm trying to show a torn bicep. So anyways, yeah, this is the last book I wanted to show you. See, it's got a great thing of the skeletal system, people lying down even, it's stretching in different ways. This, I use this for reference to learn how this muscle stretches. Anyways, really great book. So if you're looking for something that has a lot of reference, obviously it's not going to teach you how to draw this stuff, but for reference, I think it's unbeatable. Ah, all right, so I guess that's it. Peace, God bless, and stay fantastic, everyone.